Good afternoon. Hello to everybody around the world. I'm Adam Cooper, your president of the Biocommunications Association, and this is Biocom 2021. First, I'd like to introduce our director of conferences, Connie Johansson, who will introduce our speaker for today. Connie?
Good morning. Thanks, everyone, for being here. Hussein Ibrahim retired as director of medical illustration and AV services at the Health Sciences University, South Africa. He's been a member of the BCA since 1984. He served for 45 years as a medical and forensic photographer and belongs to seven other professional societies. He's got several awards, including the British Medical Journal Award of the RPS, and he's delivered 238 oral presentations. So this will be number 239. So without any further hesitation, I'm going to hand it over to Hussein.
Hello, good evening to all of you. Greetings from Cape Town. Our time in Cape Town is 7 p.m., 7.05 p.m. I'd like to thank Connie and also Adam for giving me this opportunity to share some of my research work on Kirlian photography that I started in 1979. Whilst a trainee medical photographer at Charing Cross Hospital in London. And this study was undertaken for my higher exams in medical photography. If you are wondering what Kirlian imaging is, then this is an example of the aura of an individual who was a participant in my research. I will discuss this image a little later in our talk. Here we see images of the effect of consuming alcohol and how the aura has been affected. The introduction, electrical processes in the body can be measured. Elements in the body, human body, sodium, potassium, calcium, and magnesium have a specific electrical charge. Atoms have electrons carrying negative charges. Is it possible for minute energies to have an effect on body cells and chemistry? It would seem obvious that electricity, magnetism, and electromagnetism should be playing some part in the overall maintenance of functions within the human body. Kirlian imaging is also known by the following. It is a method of obtaining an image of high energy interaction between a subject and an applied electric field. No externally applied light is used for this technique. Kirlian photography introduced biological electrographic exploration to the scientific world. Previous researchers include the Kirlians, Inushin, and there were a few other researchers as well. And my research started in 1979-1980, as I mentioned, at Charing Cross Hospital in London. In my findings, the aura showed co-emission of electrons, which is related to the amount of free electrolyte on the skin surface. This diagram shows how an image is formed by generating a very high voltage. The light emitted as photons from the electrical interaction produces the image on the film. In this image, the technique investigates human functional states by electro-optical parameters of the skin that are based on the registration of the physical processes emerging from electron components of tissue conductivity. It extracts information about the sympathetic and parasympathetic activities within the body. precautions have to be taken into consideration when working with the Kaelian equipment. The voltages range from 1,500 to 300,000 volts. You need to be knowledgeable. Special precautions have to be taken with patients with a history of heart disease and those with implanted pacemakers. The slide shows that Western governments have shown little interest in Kaelian imaging techniques in healthcare. Alternative systems of medicine, such as homeopathy, chiropractic care, oriental medicine, Ayurvedic medicine, and traditional medicine are practiced in certain countries. I use this equipment supplied by Electroimaging in the UK. This is a power unit consisting of a high voltage, high frequency pulse transformer. This unit consists of the metal plate to which the high voltage is applied. A layer of insulating material is between the plate and the subject. On your right, you have a plate that has a see-through glass that can be used with the system to record motion. In the early 1900s, Dr. Walter Kilner at St. Thomas's Hospital, London, discovered that by looking through glass screens stained with diocyanine dye, he could see an aura around the human body to diagnose illness. The Kaelian camera power unit, the technical features consists of the following: the exposure timer, air-operated start switch, and importantly, it also has a key-operated safety switch. So in terms of people tampering with the equipment and to be very, very careful when photographing the patients. And it also has an excessive temperature safety cutout, and it's suppressed to prevent interference with other electronic equipment. During the study and the research, a radiation monitoring badge was worn to monitor any spurious radiations. There was no evidence of X-rays being emitted. This is a graphic representation of the trace formation of the Kaelian image, time plotted against the voltage. Here you see a South African coin. Kaelian imaging attracts so much attention, and there is so much uncertainty amongst people about the technique. In this inorganic, inanimate object, the moisture content and the chemical makeup is relative to the amount of energy applied, showing the surface details beyond the rim. The frequency, voltage, current, as well as pulse duration plays an important role. With human fingertips, the accepted theory is that the normal, healthy, well-balanced person has an all-over even blue ring around the finger. The proximal electric medium. This is the level at which energetic exchange between the organism and the electrical environment takes place, generated by biological activity. When anxious, excited, or aroused, a red cloud-like patch or patches occur superimposed upon the normal blue aura. When influenced by intoxicants, the red glow increases, which also appears in tobacco smokers. This may also possibly demonstrate a more general and well-known effect of nicotine, that of the peripheral vasoconstriction of blood capillaries. It also affects the nervous system and over a period of time, the reflexes of the knees. The bleeding leaf effect. The red blotch seen here is a result of a scalpel cut. Immediately upon having cut this leaf, I had photographed it and I've labeled this the bleeding leaf effect. This has led to the understanding that there is in each living organism an energy matrix that provides an underlying structure of its material body. These are two images of male subjects with healthy auras, but there is almost a detectable defense line between them. The aim of the study was to separate fact from fiction and to establish a database. During the course of the study and the research, the following variables were investigated: emulsion choice, operating voltage, exposure time, the dielectric nature, ambient temperature, pressure, relative humidity, and also ionization. I may add at this point that this entire study was done using photographic emulsion. Scientists felt that it was difficult to comment with any reliability what the aura was showing. Hence the reason for investigating the variables and to standardize the technique. In this study, Ektachrome 200 ASA 35mm film and 5x4 Ektachrome and Fujichrome color film were used. Ilford FP4, and I also used Kodak Tri-X with a black and white images. The operating voltages that I used throughout the study, and also when I returned to South Africa in 1982, I continued with it. I used 1,500 volt, and I used during the investigation of the variables, various exposure times were used, ranging from about 5 seconds up to 20 seconds, and I standardized on 5 seconds. And in terms of the dielectric nature, in the research done by other researchers and investigators, they would use a dielectric where they would use a spacer between the emulsion and the plate. I used the base of the film to act as a dielectric. The temperature studies were done between 4 degrees centigrade up to 35 degrees centigrade. I standardized on 20 degrees centigrade. And the pressure, it was a light, medium, and a firm pressure. And the physics department at Medical University of Southern Africa had devised pressure-sensitive transducers which were fitted to the underside of the hand so that even pressure could be applied at all times. The relative humidity experiment was done at 56%, 73%, and 90%. And I standardized on 56%. And then the ionization, it was done in normal air and also the ionized environment. And one interesting thing that I'd like to just mention at this point, during the time of the study, the ionizer was on in the department over a period of time. And it was quite interesting that the output of the staff, the productivity had increased with the ionized environment in which they were working. So maybe all heads of departments should have an ionizer in their departments. The standardization of the technique, the resulting images do detect differences in mental and physical well-being. Here you see the three images of the same person photographed within a few seconds of each other. And I hope you will agree that there is a remarkable difference between the three images, because the important thing that we have to remember and understand that the aura is dynamic, is changing all the time. Thought forms affect the output of the aura itself. Left-hand diagnosis, hands and feet have an abundant supply of nerve endings that reflect small changes in energetic properties of the mind and body. Here you have the left-hand diagnosis, the thumb. We have limb drainage, the lower jaw, thorax, the lung, upper jaw, maxillar sinus, frontal sinus. These are related to the acupuncture points. And on the left-hand diagnosis, on the middle finger, you will have the allergy, you have the pancreas, stomach, and various other organs. Now, we on the left-hand diagnosis, the reverse applies for the right hand. So on the right hand, the middle finger, the circulation will be on the left-hand side and the allergy points will be on the right-hand side. The kidneys, the uterus, the bladder will be on the left-hand side. The pancreas will be on the right-hand side. It may seem strange at first to consider that images of the radiations from the fingers and toes may give a detailed diagnosis or possible clue to a present problem. There is a basis for this based on the acupuncture meridian or energy pathways which link organs of the body that start or finish on the fingers or toes. Questionnaires were completed by volunteers to test any predisposition or preconceived ideas about Kirlian imaging. Female volunteers had to complete the questionnaire indicating day 1 to 28 for their menstrual cycle due to the influence of hormones on mood and general well-being. This image shows one result where a member of staff who reported of sick with gastric problems. At no time was the subject aware of his Kirlian results or significance, so any psychosomatic influence could be ruled out. During this time of the research again, 12 members in the department were photographed morning and just before going home time. So this individual that was a healthy image, this was a day 1, and something was happening that you could see that the images and the strength was beginning to fall away and the brilliance of the actual image. The member of staff reported or sick day 2 and day 3. Upon returning to work day 4, the aura started returning to normality. Day 5, it had returned to its original state. So what I'd just like to mention, as a result of this study, I was able to predict the 12 members of staff that were photographed as to who was going to be off sick. Not that I was a fortune teller, but it was based, for example, on the Kirlian images. The effect of alcohol. The more alcohol consumed, the more intense the redness becomes. This is a control, and this is a result of taking whiskey every half an hour over a 2-hour session. So this was after 1 hour, this was after 2 hours. Alcohol contains matter which on breaking up volatilizes with some of it passed from the physical to the astral state. It may also contribute to depression. On the left is an image of a male on his own, and on the right image in the company of an intimate partner. The colors in which thought forms express themselves are hence identical to the colors found in the aura. The colors of the Kirlian image can also show physiological activity of the sweat glands. A high sodium content of sweat gland secretion produces a yellow, orangey color characteristic of the spectral lines, invisible light of sodium and its compounds. A reduction in the concentration of potassium in perspiration produces an orange-red color. Discoid lupus erythematosus, a chronic skin condition with inflammation and scarring, the involvement of the skin dominates the clinical picture. These images, the patients that come in for general medical photographs and then also Kirlian photographs were done at the same time, obviously with the patient's consent. Skin cells build up and form scales together with itchy dry patches in psoriasis. This is a chronic disease characterized by reddish marginated patches with silvery scaling. Here is an acute case of neuralgia. This may be taken as an example of the manner in which the nervous system operates upon the aura. Pain is caused by irritated nerves. Above, you see the image of a depressed subject, and below, the same subject after treatment and recovery to physical and mental health. Coronaluminosity. Many of the conditions which have been found to decrease the aura luminosity are also found to be sweat inhibiting. Conditions which produce and increase coronaluminosity are also found to be ones known to produce hyperhidrosis. Imaging techniques which look at electromagnetic change around living structures could possibly benefit from Kirlian imaging. A clear relationship exists between the evolution of the clinical symptoms and the modification of the electrical emissions. This image is a result of a subject allergic to the color developer of the E6 process. Notice the clumping and gaps in the aura. Lupus paniculitis is an inflammation of the fatty layer of the skin, which is crops of fat that lead onto the Weber-Christian syndrome. It may occur as a separate disease or coexist with discoid lupus erythematosus. To check and confirm the reliability of the Kirlian process, infrared color film was used to record the affected areas, the Kirlian image and the IR image. Here we have a close-up view, again, of lupus paniculitis with a Kirlian image and the infrared image. Rheumatoid arthritis is a chronic inflammatory disorder that can affect more than just joints. On the left is an image of an individual imaged for the first time using the Kirlian technique. there was a degree of apprehensiveness. And on the right, a few hours later, there is a definite and distinct change. Notice how the outer lines join the tips of the fingers, thus enclosing the electrical emission. A patient presenting with gastroenteritis, which is an infection of the digestive system. You could see the actual fallout and the change in the actual color. Inflammation of the kidney. There's quite a lot of inflammation compared to the normal Kirlian image of inflammation that has just fallen by the wayside. On the left is an image of stress where Kirlian imaging records changes in emotional states. Emotional states are known to influence the skin on chemistry and electrical impedance. And on the right, 2 days later, the stress image was beginning to change following therapy. This is throat infection where AcuTouch pointers were used. The AcuTouch pointers produce a continuous flow of negative ions, which are amplified in the hexagonal AcuTouch pointer point. This therapy dilates the capillaries, increases the metabolism, and improves blood circulation and activates the lymphocytes to improve the immune functions. A case study was undertaken of a subject undergoing this treatment for a throat infection. The Kirlian images demonstrate the effect that the AcuTouch therapy had on this condition. This was day one, day three, day four, and back to its original day six, to its normal status. Eczema is a condition where patches of skin become inflamed, also called ectopic dermatitis. And you can see the, I call it the disorganization of the actual flares that have been emitted from this image and broken up in just many, many areas. There's no uniformity in terms of the actual flares itself, with spikes of bright lights given off along the actual flares. This is a patient with low back pain radiating to the leg, the sacral point inflamed. This subject suffered from lower back pain in the sacral region. The reddish flare on the right-hand side of the index finger coincides with the sacrum point indicating inflammation. The Kirlian image demonstrates that all matter has a flare pattern, whereas organic matter has a changing flare pattern. Two individuals in a state of relaxation. Kirlian photographs of relationships demonstrate an unseen universe of human energy, a universe of communication that parallels the conscious thoughts and actions we direct towards one another. These two individuals who are in a state of relaxation lend themselves to a blue-white aura. This gaps in the fingertips, psychological cramping, pressure on blood vessels, contract the muscles. This can occur on one or more fingers. This does not depend on the proximity of the next finger. I have found more cases of psychological cramping than of physical cramping. the intrusion of another energy field, the pattern seen on the top of the finger is caused by the intrusion of another energy field. And at this point, I would just like to mention that you could take two individuals you have never met before, and you could photograph them on the same plate. And if they are to get on well, you'll find that the images, the flares, would merge. And if they're not going to get along with each other, you'll find that the images, the flares, would go in different directions. This was a renal transplant patient on medication. The convenience of this particular patient was it was a member of staff in my department who had a renal transplant. This is a control image of a patient who had a kidney transplant taken the following day before any medication was administered. After the administration of medication, a color change started to take place. 1 hour later, 2 hours later, there is a distinct change and the return to a healthy auric image despite the non-uniformity of the streamers. A few days later, after medication, to confirm the analysis and its possible potential. So this one that was taken a few days later, I took it after the medication was taken a few hours later, and it ended up very similar to the 2 hours later where I had followed the subject over a period of time. A close-up view of a leaf revealing the aura beyond its borders. Instead of seeing the surface of the leaf as it appears to the eye, we find an internal structuring of bubbles which cannot be seen with the naked eye. Pathological changes in a leaf. A close-up view of the edge of a leaf. During pathological changes, a leaf gives different distinctive image characteristic of the biological condition. Note the shade of color and the uniform streamer formation. There is a close relationship between the Kerlian technique and acupuncture. Kerlian imaging can be used to locate acupuncture points, which are also referred to as electrodermal points. This is the acupuncture point on the inside tip of the right hand little finger on the energy pathway to the heart. If the intensity, color, and location of the flares can be interpreted, healthcare workers might have a window in the condition of organs like the pancreas, brain, that are often difficult to diagnose. Kerlian imaging confirms that the highest healing science deals with this invisible level of energy. This acupuncture point is related to gastric and intestinal problems. And on the right is an acupuncture point at the high magnification. It's what I refer to as zones of cutaneous electrical activation with regard to the actual bright region. And the interesting thing that I had picked up with Kerlian photography when recording the acupuncture points, that within the actual points, there were other colors that were revealed in the actual point itself. Now, this patient as well had come into the department to be photographed with gastric problems, which was part of the diagnosis of the patient. So when I did the actual Kerlian images, it showed up the actual point related to the gastric and intestinal region. So, and I didn't realize this until well into my research that there was always this point that was showing up, and that was actually the acupuncture point that was referred to the organ where there was some form of malfunction or problem with the actual organ. The different sizes of acupuncture points are determined by the degree of electrical activity. Conflict patterns with irregular radiation. If emotions, mind, spirit, and subtle energy all have an influence on matter, and this is in fact the experience of most individuals, then the knowledge of this should transform the manner each patient is dealt with. Electrographic imaging of the body reveals the importance of electromagnetic events in and around the body. Here again, and this is a common problem, even in my previous department as well, where there are personality problems or unhappiness in the work environment, this is a typical type of image that you would pick up when photographing individuals where there are these huge gaps in the aura. Tension, this refers to mental strain. Kirlian imaging reveals our emotions and psychological states which are directly expressed within our energetic body. Sometimes we cognitively understand that we have worked through our issues. However, our bodies have not been energetically relieved or discharged of the issue. The fact that all biological processes are fundamentally electric, it is important to have an open mind and realize the potential of Kirlian imaging in monitoring patients' response to therapy and treatment. I hope and trust that this presentation has gone some way in closing the credibility gap to understand the importance of small and electromagnetic change in and around the body as being significant in both health and disease. I thank you.
Thank you. That was awesome. How many of us are ready to try it?